Hello and welcome to a new weekly vlog. What is the date today? It is Tuesday, the 24th of January. It's my sister's birthday. She's 26. I can't believe it. It is 5 degrees outside. I don't need to leave the house today, which is great. And it is about 20 to 12. I can't believe it's taken me this long to get ready. Yeah, my to-do list for today. So if you're familiar, I'm a flying tiger. I'm obsessed with it. I remember the first time I ever went in one, I was like, what the F is this? And I've been using these for I have been using these planners for like 6-7 years now. And basically, it's a calendar, but it's for, I think people stick it on the fridge, but it's a calendar for the week. It's the exact set date, so like Tuesday, October the 11th, like blah, 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 whatever it is. And I'm someone who, I can't, like a calendar on my phone. I obviously rely on technology a lot, but I don't love it. I don't like to have to rely on my phone for things. Like I still have notebooks, I still have physical diaries. I have like an actual diary and I have this. And as well, because I don't like squares, so you know a calendar with the squares, and my brain doesn't work in squares. You know how like when you think of numbers and the days of the year, mine goes like that. So when I think of a year, I think January, February, da, da, da. It's all like vertical. Today I've got medical role play in the afternoon. That's actually in 2 hours. I've got a couple of self tapes to do, some content for a brand. Yeah. And Faisal's home. Hopefully my room light. Because there is a brand I'm working with. Need a they just need one particular shot. Do that now. Does anyone else forget how short they are? I'm like, I'm actually quite short. Do I want a light? I don't think I need this other. I've been chatting with a brand that I haven't used yet, but I'm excited to because I see the word vegan. I'm like, oh, okay. So they've sent me some goodies in here, and yeah. I've got a little brief, and which is nice because a lot of the work I do is like for the brand's channel. You look really cute and cozy. The setup. Wait, let me. That's the setup. I've got a brief. It's like a loose brief, and they basically like sent me photos that I've posted that they like, and they want it along those lines. So I'll do that with my little goodies. This is where I'm going to be sitting doing my role play in a bit, because Faisal and Kadeem are going to be working on some music. So I'm going to do it in bed because it's easy. This little bean is probably going to be asleep at my feet. Tuts. I'm back in bed. Will not stop eating my feet. He thinks it's a toy. I'm sat here. About to do medical role play until 6. Yeah, I'm just ready to log in and start this exam. My feet are here, right? he thinks, I don't know what he thinks, but yeah. Anyway, let's do this exam. I'm not being funny, but this is so like, this is our walk home. I would never not love that this is our walk home. It's so pretty. I have never looked this rough at a gig in my life. I was literally in bed and Faisal was like, right, come on, we're going. Where? We're off to, no, it's okay. You see us in a club. Good afternoon, Saturday, and our food shopping arrived hours ago now, actually, but I've just been getting ready. So you want to see what's in my food shop? I don't know. So, protein bagels. Because my plan is with the protein bagels, I've got scrambled tofu with spinach on the protein bagel with like smashed avocado, tomatoes, and yummy stuff. So, spinach, pineapple, applewood. These yogurts from Asda are so nice. They're just a nice little snack, or we like to have them with like seeds and nuts and fruit. Banana. Big thing is straws. I like to put strawberries in the strawberry yogurt. I do. Spicy rice noodles with beetroot. Again, womb healing, fibroid healing. Loads of chilies. I hate how it's all in plastic, but these are my favourite. They're the chestnut ones, yeah. Chestnut mushrooms. Another cabbage. Oh, I already got carrot. Another bag of brown onions. And they didn't have the one of red onions, so we've got some big boys. Another pita kit. It's in every shop. I ordered spinach noodles because I was just like, it's a gimmick. So I'm not even a focus, but what's the fringe doing? Just what? So they replaced it with beetroot noodles. I don't think there's any nutritional value in these, but I'm intrigued. So chicken tonight. This, we used to have this all the time as kids, and I think it would be really good with fonio and just loads of veg. This is nutty for us. Instant vegetable stock. Gluten-free gravy, sauerkraut. I don't think I've ever had sauerkraut in my life, but it's another good way to get more cabbage in, and I've heard it's really good for you. Faisal's favorite item on the shopping list, smash for the roast. They did have tender stem, which is my favorite broccoli, because apparently I am rich and posh now. I'm not. Hand-harvested amaranthine. It's different broccoli anyway. I love broccoli. Fresh chilies. Faisal picked up my favorite. So guys, this is my favorite Hummus. It's the Abraham, and you don't get it from like every shop. It's just like a particular shop that you have to get it from. So I couldn't do it in my actual order. So Faisal had to go and pick it up for me. Squish. I was a bit naughty. I got a naughty treat. Sweet sort of popcorn. What's your preference? Because I have to have both. Again, we picked up an orange cap. Sorry. You know it's hard for rich and vegan. It's actually in Asda. It's 70p cheaper to get the frozen one. Now, oh my god, like I'm absolutely fuming because like we actually asked for organic baby potatoes. And they did actually have baby potatoes. So they've sent just organic white potatoes.
Potatoes.
And then lemons and limes.
We are addicted to vitamin C in this gap. That's the food shop. Bye.
Yes. When I said we were going to take it back old school, we're going to bring a friend out with us for this next song. So before we go any further, make some noise for the wonderful Faisal from Love.
Oh, shit.
That's one of the funny old boys. Cool. So, this next song is out to him, and thanks for everything he did for this fucking band. This is a song called Penance, and it's gonna be emotional, so let's go.
Fuck it!
Of my face compared to my body right now. Just been in a steaming sauna.
I have had last week such a strange but lovely week, and I almost, like, I always reflect on the week on a Sunday evening, and it was amazing, but it was also really strange. So I started off thinking, oh, I'm just gonna vlog a normal working week for me, because like I said before, I like to look back on vlogs and be like, oh, that's what I was doing. But then on, was it Tuesday? Yeah, Tuesday evening, I'd been doing medical roleplay, and then I was doing my notes from medical roleplay the next day. So I was like going through my character notes and thinking, oh, bless them, they're dealing with this. Then I got a call from my own GP, and I got some kind of diagnosis for what is going on with my periods and my uterus. And whilst it was good to get some news, it also, it was a bit of a shock to actually hear something. It's not formal diagnosis. It was just a call from my GP to be like, look, we've got this and we've got that. I won't go into too much detail because I think I've already said I think I want to do an actual video on it. I now know a reason why I am going through everything I'm going through. So one of the main symptoms for me at the minute is fatigue, which is really frustrating. I won't go into it. So it was just, yeah, it was strange. And then I also got a bit upset thinking, oh my gosh, I can't believe my body's going through this and I haven't had any help. Or, like, for instance, I begged and begged and begged and begged and begged and begged and begged for months for a scan, like an ultrasound, because, like, you can pick things up from them. And I wasn't getting anywhere. It took months to get that. I finally had it done. Then it took 3 months to get the results back, when I was told when I had the scan, oh, you'll know in a week. So after a week, I called up the doctor. I've been chasing it. And it turns out that my diagnosis, which is something that needs to be sorted out quite soon, was just sitting in the hospital and no one thought to get in contact. It's a very long story, but I am on the route of, like, maybe suing. Well, no, I want to sue. There's medical negligence there, and it's pretty bad. But I'm okay. So it essentially just kind of, like, messed up my plans. Not messed up my plans, but it changed my plans for the week. I had plans to, like, see people and see friends or whatever, and it was kind of a bit like, oh yeah, no, like, this is your priority now. So that's that. And then I was in bed on Wednesday night, because I'd done a full day of roleplay, and that is tiring. Like, I don't like sitting down all day. I just don't. I like lying down when I go to bed. Apart from that, I just like to be. So I was in bed, it was about 8 p.m. and Faisal comes in the room and he's like, I'm gonna go see 1975, do you wanna come? It was 8 p.m. I was like, when are they on stage? And he was like, oh, in half an hour. I was laying in bed, like, hair scraped back, like, mask on, all, like, moisturising my pyjamas, ready to feel like a new woman. And Faisal was like, well, do you want me to get you in as well? And I'm there like, okay. So then I just got dressed and we went. And they came on stage and I was like, I was in bed half an hour ago. Amazing performance, very dramatic. Loved the performance, it was a really good show. And then Faisal and I had such a lovely, lovely, gorgeous weekend. Our friends in Holding Absence were playing in Liverpool, and I don't think they've played in Liverpool before. And so obviously, like, the whole gang were up, the whole crew, and so Faisal used to be in Holding Absence. So yeah, we, like, as soon as they got to Liverpool about just after lunchtime, and then we met them by the Beatles statue, and then we just had a really cool time hanging out with them, and then the show was fantastic as always. I love seeing Holding Absence live. I have seen them a lot. A lot! I just love watching them live. Like, what a band. It's just banger after banger after banger. And Faisal joined them on stage and played Penance with them. Took it back to whatever year it was, but yeah. That was really cool. And my sister Lola's a big Hot and Absence fan. Ever since I was in one of their videos, she's like, this band are amazing, and there's a huge fan, so she was chuffed to come and see them as well. And I am insufferable. Like, I tweeted it, whenever I'm at a show and I hear a song live that I'm in the music video for, I will be like, I'm in this video! I'm in this video! And I got to do that twice. It's happened a few times where I think the most I've got to do that, I think, was three times in one day at a festival. And a year and a half ago, I was in a Void of Vision video, and I haven't had a chance to see them live yet. So I haven't heard that song live. And I finally saw them live, and I got to meet Jack, and he was like, it's nice to finally meet you. I was like, yeah, me too. It was so nice seeing Faisal jump on stage, because I actually saw Faisal in Hold and Absence years ago. I think they were supporting Young Guns, and I, no disrespect, I couldn't remember it. I couldn't remember it that I saw him, but I was at that show, because Faisal was like, I played that show. And I'm like, did you? There have been a few moments in like the past where me and Faisal have either been in the same room or near each other and had no idea that like each other existed. And knowing that there were so many times when we could have met. Like, there was one show, someone was like, come. Something in my head was like, no, I can't. And I could, but I said, I'm sorry, I can't. And in my head, I was like, I don't know why this guy's asking me to go to the show, but I'm saying no. And I wasn't really listening to Loathe at this point. And then I'm like, oh, because it wouldn't have been the right time. It's crazy. My HA babies, so nice. And then on the Sunday, a couple of us went for brunch at the Vibe in Liverpool. The Vibe in Liverpool, amazing, 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 amazing. Oh, but before that, I can't get my head around. I mean, I can, but Faisal is, like, I can't believe I'm married to him. I can't believe how much, like, the amount of stuff he does for me because he wants to. To me, it's, like, insane. Like, I do the same thing to him, but, like, to have someone do that to me, I can't. He's so kind and, like, he just gives and gives and gives and gives and gives. Like, he's constantly providing. Like, he just constantly, like, is going out of his way for me, which is what we do for each other, but it's, like, I don't know how to explain it, like, but to him, he's, like, well, of course. Like, he does all these mad things for me. Yeah, I saw that. I'll do that. Yeah, I'll do that. And, like, to him, it's, like, it's not an effort. And I'm, like, which I obviously feel with him, but I've never quite had that before. I've never had that before to that extent. So Faisal joined this, like, really cool gym. It's, like, a health club, like, spa, whatever. It's got really good gym, yoga studio. It's got swimming pool, jacuzzi, steam, sauna, like, all that kind of stuff. And Faisal went in there and he was like, yeah, whatever, just got like an annual membership, just got the year membership because you save money, quite a lot of money by doing it that way. Anyway, he was there and then he was like, I need to take you. He was like, it'll be really good for your womb, it'll be really good for this. So he's like, right, Sunday morning. So Sunday morning we wake up really early and we go and we get in, have an amazing time, like steam and sauna. We literally just went in the steam room and the sauna for ages, but it was amazing. And we get out and he's like, do you want a membership? I'm like, okay. Just like, yeah, it just gets me like a whole year's membership because he's like, I know how good this will be for you. And I miss the gym so much. And it's a 5-minute walk from where we live. So I'm very excited. I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful. And gratitude is my favorite thing to practice, actually. And now it's Monday. I have a massive Russell. I also have a microphone. I've got a lot of content to film, but I can't film the content until I'm sent the script. So I'm kind of just ready, like in limbo. Hi, I got a parcel from Holland and Barrett. And I thought, sorry, just why a cat's the biggest distraction? It's like my Faisal's trying to write music and Turtle is screaming in his face and he's like. I bought loads of stuff. For, again, trying to heal my uterus and everything naturally before I think about like, you know, surgery. I got two apple cider vinegars because there was someone on TikTok that has like a shot of this with garlic and grapefruit juice every morning, and it like helped dissolve her fibroids. I have garlic every day anyway because I am that kind of person that whatever I'm cooking, it's onions, garlic and chili. Also, I haven't had green tea so long. I drink herbal tea every day, but people like the green tea. I've been drinking green tea since I was about 16. I'm 28 now, so I've been having it for a long time. Again, coconut water if you are dehydrating and stuff. Or suffer with a lot of loss on your period, then I do recommend this. And then I got two of these. Holland and Barrett, a lot of the time, is like buy one, get one free, or buy one, get one half price. So it's a really good place to get supplements and vitamins and stuff from. It's this. And it actually is specifically for women experiencing premenstrual symptoms. So I got two of those. I've never heard about it before. I think there's different names for it, like Vitex or something like that. And then the rest of the things in here are just chocolate, because Holland & Barrett is probably my favorite place to get. This sounds like I'm doing like an influencer ad. It's not. I have presented for them before, which I will leave the link below if you want. What I eat in a day as a vegan. Two of these, an antioxidant fruit bar. It's dark chocolate. The percentage of cacao is 93%, I think. Nice. And then the little vegan Smartie. And then two milk chocolate bars. I feel like they're shaped like Terry Chocolate Orange. I did have two of these, the vegan Buenos, but a certain Mr. Faisal had one. Two of these. These are probably my favorite. My all-time favorite. Two of these. And I think this is my microphone. Classic Rode NT-USB. Recommended to me by my agent, because my agent actually has a voiceover agency, and I have been wanting to get more into like voice work for a long time. Sorry, turtles are literally inside the bag.
Welcome to the EE voicemail service.
The next train to arrive on platform one will be the...
I'd love to do that. I really need to get cracking with filming. Oh, it's Faisal.
Oh, sorry, I put your piece.
Okay, so it's a few hours later. And I've basically just been spending that whole time filming these TikToks of this brand. And then now I'm filming. So this is my current sitch. I'm just shooting some B-roll. And then this little baby is just watching me, looking so cute and so small.